All right, so now we're going to talk about how to diagnose this condition, what they call pneumonia. Okay, we'll talk about how to diagnose them. So, what can be the things where we actually, if you use, diagnose this medical condition? The first on the list, where they're very common and easy, where we do, now X-ray. Okay, so the patient, when the patient come hospital, the doctor go run X-ray. Chest, particularly chest X-ray, so that the doctor will see actually how the lung field look like. Okay, so you can see consolidation, or you can see patchy consolidation. If you see full consolidation, like for his case, like in case of lobar pneumonia, you can come know see from that X-ray now. You can suspect streptococcus, right? Which is in the case of streptococcus pneumonia, which is a community acquired acute pneumonia. So if you see patchy consolidations on the lung field or inside the lung field for the X-ray, you gonna see that one na bronchopneumonia, and it usually na atypical microorganisms like mycoplasma, chlamydia, Q fever, that particular microorganism where they call Q fever, Coxiella bonetti. Okay, now them they mostly responsible, even interstitial self. Interstitial, where they caused by adenovirus, respiratory syncytial virus, even Legionella, those ones, when you see those patchy kind of settings on the lung field, when you check, do the X-ray, you're going to see those ones actually are caused by atypical or interstitial pneumonia agents. So you see, say, from X-ray itself, immediately, if you don't know waiting be the problem, and waiting there at fault, and waiting if you use straighter. Okay, all right, the next thing are from the sputum. Okay, we will take sputum from the patient, and sputum, that means patient will produce saliva, and then we'll take them for gram stain, okay, and culture. All right, so we'll take the sputum for gram stain and culture. So when we culture the sputum, we will know whether now which bacteria or which other bacteria is there. Most of the time, this stain is negative for atypical bacteria, but in any case, okay, it's very, very important for you to carry out that particular procedure. Now, some other tests where we also do in very other extreme cases, we could do thoracocentesis as well. Sometimes we even do lung biopsy, you know, to actually check what they actually happen to the lungs. Okay, so even bronchoscopy self, we even do bronchoscopy, we will put something inside, check down into your bronchus to know exactly what they happen. Okay, so all these tests and all these procedures, of course, they will do the regular CBC, which is complete blood count. Doctor, then go take your blood and go check all those things as well, just to do run the general analysis on your system. But the main things now, X-ray, sputum, and in case of other extreme situation, they even do lung biopsy. So just for you to know, say that one, they also very important. Okay, now we will talk about the treatment. How can we treat pneumonia? How? What are the processes? What and what is needed in the treatment of pneumonia? When you want to treat pneumonia, okay, we actually treat them based on the severity, okay? So you check the severity of the pneumonia from the clinical presentations of the patient, and then you can understand what are the procedures of treatment, okay? If the patient get mild pneumonia, okay, when we say those clinical symptoms and features we talked before, not today evident for the patient, you go start first of all, if you treat them for, not before hospital, if you even treat them for house, if you give them the recommended medications, maybe the patient they take from house. And one of the few, I will just tell them that some of the major medications where the patients they take, but I'm not going to tell them the doses, so you have to meet your medical doctor, a medical practitioner or caregiver, make the person actually provide for you the dose of treatment based on your own peculiarity. Because another thing we say, no, they talk, say, Mr. A talk, say, when I been get this thing, now like this, then give me. So now like this, you supposed to take them. No, make your doctor check your own situation, then he go tell you what they right for you to take. Okay? So the first thing where they very, very important, obviously, you know, some antibiotics. Okay, so we'll give the patient antibiotics. If not mild, we'll treat them outside house. So the antibiotics, we'll give macrolides, right? Azithromycin, clarithromycin, okay? These one are macrolides that they call them. They're very, very good. They're very, very effective. We can also give new generation fluoroquinolones, okay? Moxifloxacin, okay? Those floxacin, okay? Those are very, very good new generation fluoroquinolones. They actually very, very help as well. All right, you also give as well second and third generation cephalosporins. You see, amoxicillin and clavulanic acid as well, very, very, very good second and third generation cephalosporins. These are very, very important medications where they give to people when they get mild condition or mild presentation of pneumonia. Now, when they get very severe pneumonia, and how can you actually tell if the pneumonia day is severe? You go see, say, the respiratory rate could be high, could be very increased. Understand? For example, you go see, say, there will be increase in respiratory rate, even more than 30. Okay? There will be decrease in sodium level. There will decrease in oxygen saturation level, even less than 94. When you see decrease, even you will see decrease in blood pressure. You understand the point? You will see all those dyspnea we will talk about very seriously. And even high fever, the level of fever could be very, very high. Even the BUN level, blood urea nitrogen level as well, could they increase? So when you see all these things, you can tell that, okay, this person gets severe pneumonia. So what you could do now, you could treat the person for hospital. And obviously, they will treat the person for hospital, and everything they will give them will be IV intravenous. Okay, they will give an IV of those antibiotics and other very important medications. We will stabilize the patient first of all before they proceed with some other checkups and updates to know exactly what will be the situation with the patient. Now, I would like to talk about what will be the prevention. How can we prevent ourselves from getting pneumonia? Now, particularly those with they for risk group, old people with they more than the age of 65, a very, very, very advisable may then take pneumococcal vaccine, okay? May then take the pneumonia vaccine. It's a very, very important. This vaccine, they very important for them. Particularly when you're more than 65 years old, you just take one shot of that vaccine, it will serve you for life. Okay, and then those will get some other diseases, like disease of the lungs, disease of the liver, disease of the heart, you know, where they really severe, you need to also take as well this vaccine. It is very, very important. And after 5 years, if you do it in a call redosing, that means if you go take the vaccine again after 5 years, just to ensure say you stay safe. This vaccine are safe and they are very, very effective, okay? Now, what will be the complications of pneumonia? Pneumonia get complications like I've been talked before, say when you know treat them, when you do them like anyhow, they say if you do anyhow, you go see anyhow. But none of us go see anyhow, okay? And they pray for all of them, and no go see anyhow for pneumonia hand. So in this case, the complications, for example, you go get empyema, or the person will get empyema. And empyema, now when this purulent process don't enter inside the pleural cavity, which is very, very dangerous. We also get what they call lung abscess, when a lot of cavities, we can't get these purulent processes as well inside the lungs. Okay, lung abscess, different cavities where they get purulent processes where they inside the lungs. As well, it's one of the very dangerous complications. Another complication we deal with this disease, now we say when it passes through the blood, okay, and it enter, for example, the heart, it will cause endocarditis, okay? It will cause endocarditis. If you enter the bone, it will cause suppurative arthritis. And if you go to the brain, it will cause meningitis. So you see, say this thing, they very, very dangerous. It is much more dangerous than you see it. We go hear pneumonia, but it's okay. Now something you go just take antibiotics, you will go. No, if you not treat them properly, you can see that it can go into the pleural cavity, it can cause lung abscess, can cause endocarditis, can cause meningitis, and even suppurative arthritis. So they very, very important. As soon as you see very terrible symptoms, will look like I'm, make you quickly go hospital. May your doctor check you. Okay? Now, the time for us to actually discuss whether if cold day, or you day under fan, or under, if you go under rain, whether you go get, whether it cause pneumonia. Let's go on a commercial break. All right, now let me explain the point. The point is actually cold, okay, fan, all those things, not the cause pneumonia. Not be the cause of pneumonia, listen to me. Not be the fan or the cold, they cause pneumonia. You see, I don't list all the causes and things where they cause pneumonia for now. And fan and cold, no day. But you must understand that during the cold weather, okay, during winter, people tend to stay at home. And they tend to stay around people, okay? And during this weather as well, the cold nature of this weather, or when rain they fall, and when you're on that fan, it they give a very good environment for these bacteria to grow and to move and to infect people and to move into people. So they easily transmitted during that period, okay? Because people they're around, they're together, and maybe one person done, so it easily transmitted through the nose, and it will get inside you immediately without even thinking about it. And also the external cover of covering of most of this bacteria also during the winter period, it make them they even much more jelly and stronger and easily to replicate and to move faster during the winter period, because of course during cold weather or cold atmosphere, because that time you need easily they destroy the covering. But during summer, hot weather, when place everywhere they hot, that cover will cover most of these bacteria, they easily destroyed. So that's why when the environment they cold, you can see that it help the bacteria to move easily. And another point also, they say when everywhere they cold, or when you walk out under rain or anything, cold weather actually they dry the mucus covering of the nose. Inside this nose, yeah, you see they get mucus layer. So if it they dry, maybe when fan they on for a long time, go they dry. And when it is dry, it easily allow the movement of microorganisms. So before you know, because fan day on, because AC day on for a long time, for this, because you day on that cold weather, that mucous membrane will day dry and easily move, go allow microorganisms to easily move down into the body and cause this condition. When I make people come to say, okay, now fan, cause I'm no. Fan they carry dust. You know those fans where we get before, and all those fans where they to they carry dust. So those dust where they come with, of course, they come with microorganisms as well. So when the nose mucus layer don't they dry, those microorganisms, say those the mucus layer of the nose gets ciliated epithelium too. So suppose they catch these dust particles. But when they dry and you know if you catch them, what thing will happen? The microorganisms go do few, it will go down inside the lungs, and it will come to cause this pneumonia we will not want to see. So that is why people think that the weather, cold weather, they cause them. Of course, perhaps in future, we can come up with more research to prove that cold weather actually they cause them. But at the moment, this is one of the explanations that is given to why people, they usually they get them during winter or during when they're under cold weather. So my people, thank you very much for being with me and being here to, being here to listen to what I have to say with my feet talk. I want us all to challenge ourselves and see what we feet do to add value to where we come from. Because they pay me very well when I see very, very simple conditions. They actually keep people for where we come from, okay? But if people, they properly educated and people they understand this condition, just like people, our friends and brothers with this other part of the world, they easily understand the anatomy and physiology of the body. I believe say we will try reduce the level of mortality, because the more you know, the more you become, you know, active enough, and you take proactive measures, you know, you prepare before it happen. You know, but if you don't know, say this fire, this thing a fire, we go burn your hand. You know, if you prepare yourself well. right? So my people, today, this one at the end of the pneumonia series, okay? If you get any question at all, if you leave them, drop them in the comment section. If you get any other topic you want us to discuss, if you drop in the comment section, so make sure say you subscribe to this our channel and share the message to your friend. And you as well, think about how you fit help, you know, the place where we come from with any other idea, with a like this or any other idea. You know, if you start your own, even in your local language as well, to ensure say your people fit connect with the health sector. It is time for us to change the dynamics in the health sector. I remain Dr. Komi Lesi. Thank you very much and see you in the next slide.